और द फिटिंग फिलॉसफी ऑफ द सॉफ्ट कॉन्टैक्ट लेंसेज, हाउ टू फिट द सॉफ्ट कॉन्टैक्ट लेंसेज। सो इन सॉफ्ट कॉन्टैक्ट लेंस वी नीड सम पैरामीटर्स। सो फर्स्ट इज अ टोटल डायमीटर ऑफ द कॉन्टैक्ट लेंसेज, वी नीड अ बेस कर्व और अ बैक ऑप्टिक जोन रेडियस, वी नीड अ सेंटर थिकनेस, वी नीड अ वाटर कॉन्टेंट, वी नीड अ मटीरियल सिलेक्शन। सो कॉन्टैक्ट लेंस फिटिंग गाइडलाइंस, सो सिलेक्शन ऑफ लेंस टाइप्स इधर द कन्वेंशनल और डिस्पोजेबल। कन्वेंशनल मीन्स वन ईयर लाइफ ऑफ सॉफ्ट कॉन्टैक्ट लेंसेज, मीन्स द कॉन्टैक्ट लेंसेज विच हैविंग अ वन ईयर लेंसेज, एंड अ डिस्पोजेबल इट्स अ वन मंथ। सो नेक्स्ट इधर डिटरमाइन द लेंस पावर, टोटल डायमीटर सिलेक्शन, बेस कर्व सिलेक्शन और ट्रायल फिटिंग। सो फर्स्ट यू शुड नो अबाउट द स्फेरिकल इक्विवेलेंट। If a patient have a low astigmatic refractive error in addition to myopia or hyperopia, a spherical soft lens may be prescribed. The prescription is based on a calculation known as the spherical equivalent. So what is the formula of this? The spherical equivalent is equal to sphere plus half of cylinder. For example, suppose we have to calculate the spherical equivalent in this case. Suppose we have a first prescription that is a minus 4 spherical with minus 4 diopter cylindrical into 180 degree. So how do we calculate? Half of the cylinder should be added to the sphere. So in this case, in first case, you can see the 4 is there and half of this is 2. So if you go for a 2, a minus 4 with minus 2 is minus 6. The same in second one, minus 8 with minus 3. In this, the cylinder is 3. You have to make it half. Half is 1.5. Now we have to add to the sphere, minus 8 diopter sphere with minus 1.5 is 9, minus 9.5. Another one is minus 12 with minus 4 diopter cylinder into 45 degree. So same as in this, 4 shaped cylinder is there. We have to make it half, that is 2. Minus 12 must minus 2, we have to add it, is minus 14 diopter spherical. So means the spherical equivalent of the last one is about minus 14 diopter spherical. So next is a lens power determination. So either you should go for a subjective refraction, example in the case of minus 4:1, or you can say the 4 diopter spherical with minus 1 diopter cylindrical at 180 degree. Second was the spherical equivalent, you should know about this, VD compensation. For example, in 4:1, or also known as minus 4 diopter with minus 1 diopter into 180, will be applied in this case. Suppose we have a power of, or the spectral prescription in first case, that is a minus 4 with minus 1 into 180 degree. So in this case, if you want to go for a simple spherical in this case, you don't want to go for a toric lens, you have to make it a simple spherical. So you have to go for a spherical equivalent in this case. So in this case, make it half of 1 is 0.5, that will be minus 4.5. same in the other case, that is minus 8 diopter spherical with minus 2 diopter cylindrical into 90 degree. So make it half of 2 is 1, minus 9, and minus in next case, minus 12 diopter spherical with minus 3, make it half of 3, that is 1.5, that will be a minus 13.5. So you should know about this. This spherical equivalent will always be applied in when you have a 4:1. So 4:1 means one ratio or one cylinder can correct with spherical equivalent. Means spherical lenses have a capacity to correct 4:1 with the help of a spherical equivalent. So suppose 4:1 means 4.5, we can go directly for minus 4.5. so if you go for double of that, 4 ka double kya hua, that will be a minus 8 and 1 ka 2. So it can be corrected. If you want to go for a 4, that will be a minus 12 diopter with minus 3. Means if you add 4 in this and you have add 1, it can also be corrected with the help of a spherical equivalence or soft spherical lenses without the toric lens. So next, for example, one of example is this, the minus 4 minus 1 into 180 is same, will not be applied in this cases. Why? Because it is not 4:1. You can see that it is a 4:2. Second, in my first, because we multiply, if we multiply the cylinder 2, that will be a 2 into 4 is equal to 8. As you can see, it is more than the spherical, so it can't be applied in first case. Second is same, we have a spectral prescription of minus 8 diopter spherical with minus 4 diopter cylindrical into 90. So if you go for a 4 into 4, 4 diopter of cylindrical and into 4, it will be a 16. So same, it is more than the 8 sphere, that is 16. So it can't be applied, 4:1 in this case, it can't be applied. Third one is minus 12 with minus 6 into 45 degree. So because if we multiply again, if you multiply the cylinder 6 into 4 into equal 24, it is more than the spherical. So it can't be applied. That's why 4:1 formula can't be applied in these cases, because you can say 4:1 can be corrected with the help of a sphere, with the help of a spherical equivalent, but 4:2 or the 8:4 or you can say the 12:6, it can't be right. So how to solve this formula? Just multiply the 4 with the cylindrical and it should not be more than the sphere. It should not be more than the sphere. So next is the vertex distance compensation. Effective lens power changes depending upon the distance from the cornea. So spectacle versus contact, it utilizes the vertex distance compensation chart to determine the proper contact lens from spectacle refraction. So we have a formula like this. As you know about this formula, we have to put the spectacle prescription in this and we have will find out the power of a contact lens, whatever with the vertex distance, but you should know about the vertex distance should be in a meters. So next, how to find out the total diameter of the soft contact lenses. So always measure the corneal size horizontally with the help of autoref or you with the help of ruler or any other ruler which can be that can be measured from each eye, from temporal limbus to lower limbus of each eye. So measure the HVID or corneal size horizontally. Just add 2 mm to HVID and select the trial lens set with nearest diameter. For example, suppose HVID or corneal size horizontally is 12 mm. So answer will be 12 plus 2, 14 mm. So total diameter of soft contact lens is 14 mm. So this is the picture regarding the measuring the corneal size horizontally or the HVID or the horizontal visible iris diameter with the help of a ruler. So this is the soft contact lens fitting or the sagittal depth. As you can see in the image, if we increase the base scope of the lens, the diameter will also increase. If we flat the base scope of the lens, and the diameter will also be flattened. So rule of thumb is same. If you increase the total diameter by 0.5, there will also be an increase in back optic zone radius or a base scope about 0.3 mm. So increase the total diameter will also affect the base scope. For example, suppose right eye K1 is about 44 at 180 degree. If you want to convert into a millimeters, there is a formula that is a 337.5 divided by 4:7.67. K2 is about 45 at 90 degree. That is 337.5 divided by 45 equals 7.5, which HVID 12. So in first case, as you know, we have to add how much point in this 0.8 millimeter to flatter scale. So means if you want to go first for base cup selection, you have to add 0.8. So as you can see in the example, 0.8 can be increasing. So 7.67 and 7.50. In this, the which one is the flattest? 41.4. You have to take 44 as a flattest, but always see in a diopters, not in a millimeters. Always take the flattest reading, means less reading in the case of diopters, not in the case of millimeters, because they are inversely proportional to each other. So as you can say, 44 having a 7.67, if you add 0.8 as base curve selection, that will be 8.47. So if you round off to this, that will be 8.5. So 8.5 will be the base curve of a soft contact lens in first case. ठीक है ना. तो next is a total diameter. We have a 12 mm. 12 + 2 is a 14 mm. Suppose we increase the total diameter by 0.5. अगर हमने इसमें 0.5 इंक्रीज कर दिया, डेट विल बी 14.5. एज यू नो वी हैव अ बेस कफ, वी डोंट हैव अ लेंस सपोज, और वी हैव अ, इफ यू इंक्रीज द डायमीटर बाय 14 to 14.5, द बेस कफ लेंस विल ऑटोमेटिक इंक्रीज, विच विल बी अ 8.18. सो फर्स्ट, इन फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी, इफ यू गो फॉर अ 14.5 mm, इन दिस केस द बेस कफ विल बी ऑटोमेटिकली इंक्रीज, डेट विल बी 8.80, 0.30 इंक्रीज. 15 mm इज इक्वल टू 9.10. If you again increase it 15.5 mm, it will 9.40. So next, in same case, if you go for an increase in a base curve, that point, that is 8.80, that will be a 14 form diameter. 9.10, that will be increase again in 15, and 9.40, that will be 5.4. So they are mainly proportional to each other. That's why it's showing that if you go for an increase in a base curve or increase in a total diameter about 0.5 mm, that will be increase in a back to optic zone radius or a base curve. So next, having measured the K, then add either 0.8 mm to flatter K, 1 mm to the average K, so for depth of flatter. So we, these three things should be applied in a formula. You have one of the options you can use for selecting the base curve in this. So this is about the rule of thumb, and this is about the adding the base curve. So first, they are saying that 0.8 millimeter to the flattest K. So which one is the flattest? In this case, the diopters you have to see, 44 is the flattest, and in this the millimeters we are getting is 7.67. So 7.67 plus 0.8 will be 8.47, rounded off to 8.5. So mean 8.5 will be the base curve of the soft contact lenses in first case. Second, 1 millimeter to average. You can do this also. Suppose right eye is same, K2 is same. In this case, we have to take the average of both in millimeters. 7.67 plus 7.50 divided by 2 will be what? 7.58. And you have to again add it to average, that is 0.80, 8.38, and again round it up to 8.50. So as you can see, in the 1 millimeter to the average of K's. So next is a 4 diopter flatter than average K. So suppose right eye 44 and K2 is this, again we have converted into millimeters. So in this the average is again 7.57. So but you have to see, now it's it in diopters, not in a millimeters. So we have to go for a diopters. So 7.58, having a, if you divide the 337.5 with 7.58, you will get the 44.52. So 44.52 diopters minus 4 diopters been eaten out, so it's in the meters, it's in the diopters. So you have to minus in a flat one or in an average K, that will be a 40.52. So 40.52 again converted into a meters, that will be 18.32, rounded off to 8.25, and it will be base curve soft contact lenses. So depending upon you, which type of formula you have to prefer in this case. Okay, but you can see there's not so much difference, just a 0.25 difference is out there. So soft contact lens fittings, trial lens fitting regarding as a essential by some, allows the feel of a lens experience, patient reaction is accessible, needs to be performed in average illumination, pupil size assessment made with the aid of a good illumination. So select the trial bag vertex power or the contact lens power, the specs power nearest to vertex criteria spectacle prescription. If only plus minus 3 diopter available, use appropriate time. If prescription is high but only low prescription trial lens is available, consider getting more appropriate trial. So always go for nearer to the contact lens power. So these are the inventories, as you can say. What are the data we required in this case is corneal size or HVID or horizontal visible iris diameter, keratometry, spectacle prescription or water distance compensation. So optimizing on eye profile, trial lens is placed on the eye first. contact lens, land lens, and allowed to settle for 10 to 15 minutes. On eye lens, performance is evaluated based on the universal fitting criteria. You have to see the corneal coverage, you have to see the concentration or lens movement. The next is the need for corneal coverage. You have to cover whole of the cornea more than the limbus, about 2 millimeter, because to prevent the mechanical or prevention of trauma. So physiological, you can say, for a corneal exposure or a corneal desiccation. As you can see in the first image, first example 3 lens 2, you can see the soft contact lens is covering whole the eye with the 2 millimeter in extra from the limbus. But in the second image, you can see the incomplete coverage. You can see the border of the soft contact lens is not 2 millimeter more as compared to the first image. So it's an incomplete coverage. So means this lens is either steep or either flat. So next is the centration problem. That's you can see that when the patient is looking up, the lens is going down. So this is due to flat lens. This is due to flat lens. Hence, because the lens is losing, that's why the lens, if the patient looks up, the vision will also be blurred in this case. So centration is not proper. So that's why the decentration is out there. So why is movement required? Removes and disperses ocular debris, promote the tear exchange, and possibly aids epithelial wetting by. So we need some movements in the soft contact lenses so that we can avoid the removes, and so we can go for a remove and disperse ocular debris, promotes the tear exchange, and possibly aids epithelial wetting by. Suppose in this case you can see the lens is totally flat when the patient is looking up and the lens is going down. In this case you have to go for a steep lens. This is a flat lens, so steep, so that the lens will also go up. But we need some movement is also there. So assessment of mobility, movement of a blink, lag following eye movement, movement on up gauge blink. So as you can see, the lens 2 and the lens 3. So lens 2, you can see in the border of this, there are some vessels out there. And in this case, the lens movement is still there in the lens. And you can see the border of the margin. This is the lens 1 and this is the lens 2. This is the lag. A lag, you can say, when the patient is looking, the lens is going down. When the patient is looking toward the right side, the lens is going toward the left side. When the patient is looking down, the lens is going up. That is the lag. Means that due to flat lens, the lens is not properly centered. The steep lens is very stable and there is hardly any lag. The flat lens is less stable and therefore lag will be more. The comfort factor will be a critical factor of contact lens case success. Steeper, tight fitting lens may be more comfortable as compared to flat. Patient will say if we go for a steeper, the patient will be more comfortable as compared to flat. Flatter lens may cause a lit sensation and discomfort. So next is a vision. So after fitting of a soft contact lens in the eye, you have to ask the patient pre and post blink, what will be the reaction? Means what will be the vision in this case? Steep lens before blinking, lens comfort. If the patient says the vision clears after blink, that means the lens is totally having a steep lens or a tight fit. Same as in a vision blur after blink, that means the patient is a patient having a flat lens. So which lens will be the ideal? In which the pre and the post vision will be the same or equal. The patient says pre blink and post blink, after means after blink and pre blink, that will be a same vision. No blurring, no clearness will be out there. So next is a push-up test. We just have to place the index finger in the lower margin and we have to put it up, make it have him just for to checking the movement of the lens. So this is the tight lens. As you can see, the lens is totally compressing the sclera. That's why you can see the lens border having some blood vessels out there, or the perilimbal vessels, you can say. So somebody choose lens that gives a proper vision, or pre and post blinks will be the same. Pre and post retinoscopy reflex should be the same. Pre and post keratometry Meyer should be the same. So that will be the ideal lens. That lens should not be having a lag, should not be having a decentration. That will be a proper, and patient is comfortable should be that. Thank you. So this is the comfort I am talking about. So thank you.